Having background music in your stream is a great way to keep your viewers engaged, especially for those moments when you're not talking as much. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to go ahead and add background music directly inside of OBS Studio without the need of having to do screen capture or having other programs open. Let's go ahead and dive in. So the first thing you're going to want to do is you want to go ahead and open up your OBS Studio. We're going to go ahead and find the scene where we're going to want to go ahead and add our music. We're going to come to sources and we're going to press this plus icon. We're going to select media source. We're going to name this music, and then you're going to press OK. Now this is going to go ahead and ask you to go ahead and locate the file for the music that you want to include into OBS Studio. Now this is going to be the best way to be able to do this because it doesn't add so much strain on your CPU. When you have other apps or programs or browser sources open, it does create a little bit of strain on your computer, not giving you the best ability to stream and have the best quality. So this is why we're going to do it this way. So you do need an MP3 file, right? So what I like to use is I like to go ahead and use Epidemic Sounds. I'll put a link in the description down below. And the reason why I like using Epidemic Sounds because they have tons of options of music you can go ahead and utilize and sound effects as well. But the most important thing is that you won't have to worry about any copyright claims because it is royalty-free music. And I like the fact that I can select my YouTube, my TikTok, my website, my Twitch, my Facebook, my Instagram, and I can use this music across all those platforms without worrying about copyright claims. This is what I personally like to use. And I went ahead and included a stream playlist that I utilized with over 3 hours of music that you can go ahead and utilize for your stream. And then it's a 30-day free trial. Sometimes they have 60 days, but if you do want to go ahead and upgrade, it's $9 a month. But again, you can get music from anywhere that you like. So once you have your music, you then want to come to Audacity. Now, Audacity is going to be the tool that we're going to go ahead and utilize to be able to put all of our tracks together to create one playlist that can run on our OBS account. So you'll go ahead and download Audacity. I'll put a link in the description of this video as well. And then once you have Audacity installed, you want to go ahead and get it opened up. So once you have Audacity open, it'll look just like this. So now we want to go ahead and get our music. So you want to come back to Epidemic Sounds and you want to come to the playlist or any of the songs that you found on Epidemic Sounds or wherever it is that you may want to utilize. And you want to come and select this little download icon. So we'll select download, we'll go to file format, we'll select MP3, and then we'll hit download. Now I'm just going to go ahead and download 3 songs, and then you can do this for as many songs as you like. So I'll go ahead and download these 3. Once you have your songs downloaded, they'll download into your files. And now what we want to do is we want to open up Audacity. We want to come to file and we want to go ahead and import audio. So we'll go ahead and go to the downloads where we went ahead and included that. I'll go ahead and select all 3, hit open. And you're going to see here that they're all going to open up just like this. So what we want to do here is we want to go ahead and drag the bottom one and just place it right after. And then you can go ahead and delete. And then you'll do the same thing for this one here. You'll grab it, bring it over, and then you can go ahead and add it directly here right after. And then you'll do this for every song that you want to go ahead and add. Now, initially, it may be a little bit daunting to do this, but typically you only have to do this once. Once you have it all in the playlist, you're going to be able to utilize it inside of OBS. So let's say that these are the songs that I want. I have my playlist ready to go. Now you want to come to file, you want to come to export, and you want to export as an MP3 file. We'll name this stream playlist 1. I'll go ahead and hit save. I'll say okay. We'll say okay again. And now that's going to go ahead and download all those songs into one file for us to be able to use inside of OBS. So now that I have that, I'm going to come back to OBS Studio. I'm going to come to locate file. I'm going to hit browse. And then I'm going to go to my desktop where I saved it. Here it is, stream playlist 1. I'm going to select that. I'm going to hit open. That's going to bring in that file directly into OBS. And then it's very important, you want to go ahead and select loop. Now the playlist that I shared with you has 3 hours worth of music. But if you only want to have 4 or 5 songs, maybe 10 minutes worth of music, if you hit loop, that music will just continue to play nonstop. So I'm going to hit loop. I'm going to press OK. And you're going to see here that now the music is playing, right? So you typically want to have the music about somewhere around here, about 30. Not as loud. You don't want it to overpower your voice. So you can see here. Now, the music by default, it's only going to be heard by your stream. So in order for you to be able to hear that music, you want to come and hit this little gear, this little 3 dots. You want to come to advanced audio properties. And then you want to go ahead and click where it says music, which is the MP3 file we just went ahead and added. And when it says monitor, you're going to have three options. Monitor only means that only you will hear it. Your stream won't hear it. Monitor and output means that you'll hear it and also your stream will hear it. So if you want to just test to be able to hear how the music sounds, once you do that, you'll be able to start hearing the music. You can start playing here in the video as well. So I'm going to go ahead and turn that off for just a time moment. I'm going to leave it on monitor off, but that's how you're able to go ahead and hear yourself. If you want to do the same thing for your mic, that's how you go ahead and do that. Now, when you have your music, you have to add it to every single scene that you want to go ahead and utilize that for. So the beautiful thing is that when I have my countdown timer, you can just press plus. You can come to media source and you're going to see here it's going to say add existing, and then you can go ahead and add that music into every single scene that you have. And now you're able to control the volume and all of your music directly inside of OBS. Now, if you want to be able to go ahead and get more followers, more donations, more subscribers, go ahead and watch this video right here where I show you how to go ahead and set up alerts. That way, when people subscribe, donate, or follow, it pops up on screen, encouraging other people to do the same. So go ahead and watch this video right here to learn how to set up alerts. I'll see you guys in the next video.